How's it going, guys? You got blue eyes, and welcome back to Dark Souls. I'm sorry for not updating yesterday. I was tired, I was sick. It was just not a good episode overall. Oh, hello, ghost. But we got a new weapon off screen because the recording messed up, because I'm stupid. And I mean, I also did most of the Undead Asylum, except I couldn't kill either the Black Knights or the Stray Demons. I kind of suck. So, you may be asking, what are we doing today? Well, we're going to the depths. The depths is kind of, well, it's not so bad if you know what you're doing. But it's kind of scary for new players. And also, we got a new weapon to our arsenal. Say hello to the Zweihander. This sword is awesome. I use this and my claymore the most in my other playthroughs. Unfortunately, we're not strong enough to wield this one-handed. As you can tell, it's because it hurts. So we have to use this two-handed, which is fine because I didn't really use shields anyway. It doesn't really make me lose anything. There we go. See, so just cleans right through everything. You can see like just how far this weapon reaches. And unlike most weapons, its forward power attack, where you swing it over your head, doesn't get caught on tight edges like this. See? And swing and die. Ooh, humanity. Nice. Yeah, you can farm humanities from rats, which is another good reason to go down to the asylum, or the depths, rather. Lots of rats. And kill them all and get humanities. Life is good. The depths are not, well, they can be hard. There are some particularly spooky enemies down there, and I said that really weird. Basilisks. If you don't know what they're doing, and you only heard what they can do, they are really scary because they have this attack where they basically surround you in this toxic fog, except if it kills you, you become cursed, and that halves your HP, and now you can see how much damage even these little nerds can do to you. Now imagine me having like half this health. Luckily, it's not gone forever. The Dark Souls guys at FromSoft are not that cruel as to like permanently screw you over if you mess up. It can be healed, but it's an expensive thing to heal. There's actually only two ways you can heal a curse in the game. One way is to go into the New Londo ruins, and the other is to buy a specific ring, which costs, I think it's like 6,000 souls or 2,000 souls. It costs quite a bit, which heals your curse once. Then there's some items that make you more curse resistant, which are good to have. I think having liquid humanities on you makes you... Oh, God, I didn't think you saw me. That is a butcher. There are two of them in this game, and I hate them. I hate them a lot. Oh, good, the stuns have been one hit. That makes my life easier. And swing. Great. And hit to you. Yeah, there we go. Look at the reach like this thing has. I'm way back here. Still got her. And yes, that is a her. A very ugly her. Probably the ugliest her in the world. Now right here, we're actually going to get one of the most important treasures in the early game. Go away, dog. There we go. Yeah, I'm on the backhand. The large ember. If we give this to one of the blacksmiths, it'll allow him to increase... I'm talking really weird. But if you give it to him, it'll allow him to increase your weapons from plus 5 to plus 10. Like, incrementally, of course. Okay, out of bolts. Now I'm going to do a plunging attack on him. And hit ya! That was nice. Right in the neck. And that thing is scary looking. Like, I've never seen it up close. But that's pretty scary. Let's grab that sewer chamber key. Useful treasure. Lots of souls down here. I think I might actually get a level up just from going down here. Oh, there's a rat. Now, rats are actually docile enemies in this game, relatively. They're more interested in, you know, doing their own rat thing than killing you. But they will attack if cornered, which is, like, I think part of their AI, which I think is pretty cool. Like, they'll detect, like, oh, I can't run away from this guy. Yes, I got it. Oh! Yeah, sorry. Quick subject. That is a slime, and I think I'm not going to do any major damage to it. Nope. But which kind of makes sense. I mean, you're hitting a slime with a hunk of metal. It's not going to kill it. I think magic and fire kill it faster. And, there we go. And one more should do it. So that took quite a few hits to kill. I don't think he drops anything worth anything. And right down there is where I fought the rat. And by fight, I mean, whoops. I mean, I shot at him for about 5 seconds and then did a drop, you know, like a drop attack on him, took him out in one hit. Ooh, he gave me a humanity. You can actually collect humanity bit by bit if you go through an area. Because I don't know exactly why. I think it's more of a gameplay thing and a bit of lore thrown in. Oops, forgot to do a thing. I need to reverse hollowing. Because there's an enemy we can fight down here. It'll give us a good deal of souls. And Kindle. Kindle makes the flame go up a little bit. Observe. But more importantly, it increases your number of maximum Estus flasks by 5. The most you can have on you, Estus flasks I mean, is 10. Or no, 20. I'm a little bit tired. But yeah, 20 Estus flasks is your maximum. Which I think is more than enough for most bosses, if you know what you're doing. There's a lot of that in this game. Like, everything is easy if you know what you're doing. Let's go for the triple kill. Yes! No, I only got the double kill. Oh, well. Any humanities dropped? Nope. And a great axe. Which, in all honesty, it's more of an okay axe at best. I wouldn't call it great. Okay, we're back, and I messed up. There's basilisks here. And luckily, I didn't get cursed right there, because I have, like, no curse resistance for some reason. And if you look at those big boobly eyes right there on top of their head, those aren't its real eyes. Its real eyes are actually, like, right under those. You can kind of see their little white dots. But I hate these guys. They're scary. But, like, you rarely, if ever, find anything inside of, boxes or crates or anything in this game, but I always check just because it's so ingrained in a gamer's head to break open boxes and find stuff. Not knocking that or anything. There's a bad thing in the Dark Souls community where the players can get a bit elitist. And I don't like elitism. Elitism. I don't know what I'm trying to say. Elitism? I don't know. Elitist mindsets. Just because, like, we're all playing a game here. It's no reason to get, like, you know, mean and try to make other people feel bad. Okay, right there specifically, if you look under its eyes, you can see little white dots. Those are its real eyes. And that's one down. Luckily, these guys go down in, like, one hit, so it's not like I'm... Shit. Oh, God, that was close. Like, unbearably close. Being cursed. Okay, I think right over here is gonna be a guy who will try to kill us. Nope. Where am I going? Ah, Ring of the Evil Eye. That's gonna be useful. I'm gonna replace that. This increases. Oh no, wait. Whoop. I thought something else. Every time you kill an enemy, it upgrades your health a little bit. Or, like, not upgrades, but gives a little bit of it back. Which is good in areas like this because there's so many, like, little enemies you can kill in one shot. It's just nice to have that sort of ring around. And right over here, you're going to see another part of the Dark Souls multiplayer thing. Right over there, Dark Knight Kirk. Now, he is just an NPC. He's nobody in real life. But he stands to show you, like, oh, this is what, you know, black phantoms look like. I don't know why they're called black phantoms. I always thought they looked more like red phantoms to me. Because, you know, they are more red. But luckily for you, he is really easy to kill. He often... he often summons himself in spots where it's, like, really easy to get the drop on him. Like, there's this spot and a couple others. Shit. Let's get away from him. Put something between us. Put another Estus. And take him out! There we go. Beautiful. Dark Knight Spirit Kirk was vanquished. Very good. I got another humanity, which is nice. And, oh, I didn't drop anything else. Sometimes he'll drop his sword or his shield or something, and that's kind of cool. Okay, back. Let's fight him again. Okay, it's just you and me again, Gaping Dragon. You, me, and Solaire. Got my souls back, at least. That's good. A good rule of thumb in fighting this guy is never fight him, like, close to a wall. You always want to be out in the open. Because if you get up close to a wall, he can actually pin you down and kill you really easily. Luckily, Solaire is... shit. Roll, roll. Okay, Solaire, hit him for me, bud. Hit him for me, Solaire! Solaire! Okay. He's focusing on Solaire again. Okay. I'm gonna roll. And hit. Good, now his tail's gone. I can hit him from behind, and Solaire is still alive. For the most part. Okay. Whack. Whack. I actually have some, like, really weird nostalgia for some of the early bosses in this game, even though I've only started playing, like, the last year. Like, fighting the Taurus Demon and the Gaping Dragon and all that, I've got really fond memories of. Despite only, you know, been doing this, like I said, less than a year. And speaking of nostalgia, I was looking through some of my old stuff, and I found... some old my Star Wars figures, you know, like my old childhood toys, basically. And I was playing with them a little bit. And for a few minutes, I was back to being a little kid in New York again. And I forgot how nice that was, you know, before I had any adult responsibilities or anything like that. You know, before I had to pay taxes and, you know, I had to make up rent because I didn't have a job and stuff like that. And I know I have a lot of younger viewers, so here's a little tip. Enjoy what you have now. Especially if you're in, like, the 14 and 15 year age range. And appreciate, like, what you have going for you. You know, you have a pretty easy life, for the most likely. For the most likely, that was grammatically correct. But... I'm not going to tell you, like, how to live your life. If you like video games or you like going outside, do what makes you happy. Because when you get older, you can't just do that all the time, you know? And this is going to sound weird. I actually learned to love video games more when I had a job. Because I didn't get to play them as much. So when I played them, it was a bit more special. So, appreciate the time you have now. When you get older, you might not be able to have 3-day long Fallout New Vegas marathons like I did over the summer when I didn't have a job or stuff like that. Oh, we have him like halfway down. I'd say about 55% down, I guess. I know it's kind of weird because, like, I know I'm young. I don't have that much life experience compared to some people my age. And there are people my age who went and joined the military and they're off fighting. I mean, I guess they're not fighting. America's not really at war. But there are people who were my age who went to, like, Vietnam and Korea and World War II and World War I and stuff like that. I don't know where I'm going with this. I'm just kind of rambling. But I was going to do a podcast about this, actually. This entire topic of appreciating your childhood. I was thinking about this more in regards to, like, the 90s kids who will say stuff like, if you remember these, your childhood was awesome and stuff like that. Now, obviously, their childhood was actually nowhere near the best because, let's be honest, 2000s kids got all stuff the 90s kids did without as much of the cringe. I mean, I am a 1997 kid, so my childhood was, like, I should say, 90s influenced. Like, there was a strong 90s influence. My sister is 21, no, like 23 or 24 at this point, actually. My older brother is going to be 20 this year. And they grew up a bit more in the 90s than I did. And my brother remembers stuff from the 90s and stuff like that. Weird commercials. And I think it's important to appreciate your childhood no matter what anyone else says. Like, go on, have fun, enjoy the music. Just because some people from the previous generation don't like it doesn't mean anything. Because everything that you really enjoy is made, for the most part, by people from the previous generation. I mean, like, even the younger music artists and stuff like that are generally around, like, the 18 and 19 age range. I said age range, I should say. And their producers are all, like, 30s and up. So, go ahead, enjoy your dank memes. You know, get all the rare Pepes. Enjoy the troll face. Enjoy the WAT. Enjoy the poker face. Enjoy everything. Enjoy Facebook. You guys have actually got it better than the 90s kids did. The 90s kids thought they had it good, but they have to deal with an economic crash that you guys didn't, for, you know, to an extent. You guys might have to deal with some of it, and you guys might have your own crisis, like North Korea might make good on its threats and attack, which is, you know, I mean, come on, and the U.S. can definitely take North Korea in a fight, and I'm just rambling. I need to pick a topic and stick with it. But I find when I ramble, I'm actually better at this game because I'm flying more on autopilot. And I missed him twice. That was embarrassing. Let's whack him a good one. This is actually some more generic growing up advice. Like, when you're fighting this gaping dragon, you just keep going. Like, I'm not doing any damage to him. But if I keep whacking him with my Zweihander, which I'm not even fully ready to use, if I just keep trying, eventually he'll go down and I will move on. It's that way in YouTube, it's that way in games, it's that way in life. Like, I might not ever become a major YouTuber. Maybe my, you know, my audience never, it's more than, like, 2,000 people, and I'm okay with that. Because I do these videos for fun and to share my thoughts. and have been recording for almost 40 minutes now. So I'm going to gather those souls, all 25,000 of them. I'm going to homeward bone. And you know what? I'm not going to end with a little gesture, but I want to say thank you for watching. And I hope you're here for the next episode. Because next time, we're heading to Blight Town, and we're going to fight Quaylog. Jesus, I can't talk.